Hello, good morning. Today I'm going to tell you a little about the most listening to music in Italy. As we well know, Italy is one of the most beautiful countries with an exceptional culture. The music of Italy is distinguished as a special musical genre in the country. The opera is recognized as the highest expression of the culture of this nation, better known as the country of the opera, where it is also a great influence of famous singer-songwriters. Italian folk songs include ballads, children's songs, songs for holidays like Christmas, songs for celebrating weddings, and other important events. Laura Pausini is the Italian singer for excellence and one of the most recognized worldwide. With a stellar musical career, the numerous albums of her with songs in Italian, Spanish, English, or French, among other languages, have made her become one of the artists with the most albums coming. Among many other awards, Laura was the first Italian artist to win a Grammy Award, making history in the world of music. Then, I will put a small part of a popular opera song in Italy.
The 15th and 16th centuries, starting for the painting in the Triscano and doing some parcel with architect and sculptor. The Kremlin did Florence for well, it will spread to the rest of Italy during the 15th and the rest of Europe in the 16th. Guido and the Florentine school are considered the starting point for the development of the Renaissance in the painting. Its main characteristics are combining the Christian, page and profound theme in front of the dominant Christian theme. Interest in both intellectual and physical mean, hence the study on anatomy in art. The painting will be distributed in the central axis to human, being humanist. A spicy perspective is subject, and studied to archer of the perspective, the lion perspective will develop. From its Venetian mindset, school began the study of Arab perspective in the 16th century. Later, another interesting aspect in painting, as it helps study the space and volume, these lights and shadows. The composition is perfect structure and study the figures and distribution. Distributed with the thread, became able to enter a triangle, a square, rhombus, circle. The figures in the world will catch another.
Hello, my name is Ana Karen Ledesma Navarro, and in this occasion, I will explain about the Italian cinema. Okay, the Italian cinema start with a silent cinema. The silent cinema began with 1,006 films until in 1920, they registered at the first patent by Filippo Alberini on November 11. In 1995, with the first film, Umberto e Margherita di Savoia a Passeio per il Parco Direct. This is the first. By Vittorino Calcina in the Second World War. Italian cinema became very famous in the historical cinema. The choir is important in Italian cinema. It's what would let it be. Now that's called the Salar or Play Film, that is adventure cinema set in classical times, characterized by its elaborate settings and mass I think the word Latin Italian filmmakers, the principal in Italia is Luigi Magni. The next are important, obviously, but the next are Pretty Jeremy, Vittorio Di Sica, Lina Wertmüller, Hermano Olmi, Mauro Bolognini.
Hello, how are you? My name is Juventino Esteban Segoviano Tapia, a student of the school Normal Number 4 in the Nezahualcoyol. Today I will present some sculptures from Italy and their most outstanding works. Let's start with the first sculptures. Donatello became the best sculptor of the first Renaissance and reviewed classical statues such as that of Saint Mark. His main work is the statue of Saint George. The original sculpture today can be found in the Bargello Museum in the Bargello Palace in the Florence, Italy. The others can be found in various parts of the world, other replicas. One of the most important of which we have all heard about it until our times. Even though we are not interested in sculptures, we have nothing less than Leonardo da Vinci. His only attributed sculpture is the Virgins with the Loading Child, which is sent before millions of peoples a year, is currently in the Victoria and Albert Museum in London. But a curious fact is that to prove that this was their work of art, they and to analyze it and compare all the works of Da Vinci to say that was work of his authorship. We learned till exposed three sculptures from Italy. I leave them with time. Goodbye. See you later.
Who doesn't like to dance and feel the music? Everyone, right? That is why today I come to tell to you about the more recognized dance in all of Italy. My name is Jocelyn Martinez, and I am going to guide you through this magical hornet of music, dance, and culture. Come to me. Typical dance in Italy. It is characteristic of the southern regions. It is dance of Napolitan origin, in which happy movements are performed at regular grids among of movements the legs, and has its musical rhythm, with each wise singing is also included. You can dance alone or in pairs. In each region, there is a tarantella that is different for the others by the span of the ring, which is why some are faster and others are slower. In order to dance, the tarantella is necessary to generate sound with different instruments. This may vary, but the ones that are always present are the flute, the tambourines, and the accordion. In addition to its one rim, this dance is recognized for the unique clothing where we find in the woman, red or black skirt with white, red handkerchief wagging, white skirt, black leather belt and silk necklace. In the men, black shorts, white socks, red hanging, white skirt, black leather vest, and red band around the neck. That is all for me. I hope you have been able to know a little more about Fort Italy.
Theater in Italy. As the first of the modern state theater, the Olympic of Vicence if of 10 seated, designed with Andrea Palladium and contemplate if, which was a version of the Roman models and present at the back of the stage, a three-dimensional perspective with urban views. The classical model of Italian theater, prevailing in many respects, was not else the finest theater in Parma.
The Italian literature represents the rich culture of the country and speak the future Greek legends that live in the country of age. The literary language of literature was Latin before the 20th century, the chronicles, the historical poems, and the religious poems written in that era were all in Latin. The Sicilian was the earliest poetry ever written in Italy. The other notable feature of the Italian literature is the epic poem of the Dante Alighieri and the Divine Comedy. The Divine Comedy is a dramatization of the medieval theology and physiology, and is a grounded through the three worlds known as the Paradise, Hell, and Purgatory. This was some basic information about the literature in Italy. The main part of the Italian literature is that it often deposits in the form of plays, theater, and movies, which try to promote the Italian culture in general.